NIO stock is crashing down 4.6% in Hong Kong today. What is going on with NIO? The Chinese stock market in general is down. And this is all due to some pretty crazy, insane pump and dumps like you've never seen before. And this is absolutely going to blow your mind. The outrageousness of this all. And of course, the NIO manager here gave me some updates worth knowing about and see where NIO stock is potentially headed to. So there's this one company called Lu Dashi, and it's listed in Hong Kong. One of the biggest shareholders owns 30% of the company, and he wanted to cash out. So what did he do? He suggested to management that they should announce a dividend, and that's exactly what they did. They announced a dividend, and the stock price instantly went from pretty much $1 to $2 Hong Kong dollars over a couple days, because you know everybody's hyped about dividends. Dividends are really nice. As soon as that happened, the big investor cashed out, selling all his shares, dumping the stock price down back to one and below, essentially cashing out. And you know what the worst part about it, this all thing is? After that dump, the price dump, the company made an announcement that because the share price is so low, we are no longer offering that dividend. Oh my God. Can you imagine the blatant pump and dump that's happening? You tell investors you're going to do a dividend just to get the share price up, and then once the big investor cashes out, then you cancel the dividend. And this, of course, has everybody rage quitting on the market, because why wouldn't you? So this other company, it's called Jiangsu Yahong Medical, Meditech. And in 2021, they only had a revenue of 4,675 RMB, which is about $600 for the entire year. And then 2022, they only had a revenue of 26,095 RMB, which is $3,568 for the entire year, revenue-wise. And for revenue for H1 of this year, 7,700 RMB, which is $1,000 for the first half of this year. This company has no product. It doesn't even have a product license. Yet management is taking in millions in salary, and cost of sales is 15 million RMB last year. And they're selling what? They don't even have a product license. I don't know what they're selling. They're selling air probably. So the stock has always been going down from 23 down to 11 where it is right now. And what's even more peculiar is the agency responsible for listing that stock for IPO gave that, it was listed at 22-ish. But the highest target right now is 16.5 from that same agency. So it's pretty dumb. And people are thinking that this is just a way for the big boys, the whales, to basically cut the leak. It's called cutting the leak. Basically get money from the retail investors. And of course people are thinking, what the hell is going on? Why is this company even listed? The impact that company has on investor sentiment in China, especially Chinese investors, cannot be ignored. People are pulling out of the market thinking it's a scam, it's a sham. Now the big question after this big dip, should we buy NIO stock? Am I buying NIO stock? Where do I think NIO stock is headed? Not financial advice, of course. So the NIO manager told me he sold 6 vehicles so far this month. Of course, that's a far cry from July, where he sold like 10 in 2 days, which is just absolutely incredible. But he's saying the competition is tough, but there's lots of test drives, which is very good. There's people interested in the car. A lot of you guys do seem to be worried about bankruptcy. Look, NIO is going to list NIO China shares domestically here in China. That means NIO Inc. is going to sell a portion of their stock in NIO China to get more money overall. And this approval has to happen no later than July of next year. So that means very soon we're going to get very good news. And listen, I do not think NIO will ever go bankrupt, because it's just, they're spending a lot of money, but there's always going to be someone that's willing to help them, all right? And they have so much infrastructure that it's just basically not possible for them to go bankrupt. People will be willing to buy up the company instead of letting it go bankrupt. And NIO CEO is capable of getting a lot of money. So in terms of that, you guys are concerned about William Li as the CEO. I am not concerned at all. I do hope that he had some help from Traditional Auto in terms of another higher up exec, but he's the one that's capable of getting us all the money. Otherwise, if it wasn't for him, knew would have been gone back in 2019. So having that in mind, and this is not financial advice, I feel very comfortable holding new stock, even though it's going down. All right, I bought some back at 12 from the pullback, but it turns out the pullback turned into a crash. Right now, we are below the 200-day moving average, and we are at around $8 a share, very close to $7. We might get even lower, but in my personal opinion, if it gets even lower, I'm going to buy more. I'm probably not going to buy right now, because right now it seems like the pessimism from the investors hasn't peaked yet. Once the pessimism peaks, that's when, you know, I should pull the trigger, in my personal opinion. But remember, down the line, many, many years later, you know, this percentage move right now is going to be peanuts compared to where we'll be. Looking at new stock right now is like looking at Tesla stock back in 2011. Yes, Tesla came close to the brink of bankruptcy back then, but they didn't go bankrupt. NIO came close to the brink of bankruptcy back in 2019, but NIO didn't go bankrupt. And I'm 90% sure that NIO won't go bankrupt in the future. So if you think investing in Tesla back in 2011, when it was down a lot, is a good idea, then perhaps investing in NIO right now would also be like a similar situation like back then when they were struggling. And the fact of the matter is, everybody right now is in similar situation. They're struggling. It's a price war. It's pretty intense. But don't forget, NIO was selling quite well. NIO is doing very well. So it seems like investors have really forgotten about the good deliveries from July and the good deliveries in August, and just focused so much on the dilution and the losses from Q2, and they've gotten things out of hand. So I'm still bullish long term. Short term, investor sentiment isn't that good, but long term, we are still good. So in terms of sales, they're doing all right. They're doing okay. About the same as last month. Lots of customers. And right now, the big shocker is NIO is going to be replacing the keys for the showroom cars, for the test drive vehicles, with NIO phone. There's going to be 2 NIO phones per test drive car. So NIO is going to be using those as keys and be able to really showcase the features, the connectivity features of the NIO phone for every single test drive. And he told me, you know, competition is still very, very intense here in China. The price war is still going on. Other guys coming out with cheaper and cheaper SUVs. Some of the guys to watch out for right now at this moment, we got the XPeng G9 2024 variant that is basically smack right in NIO's ES6 territory. I've driven that car in the past and I said it was overpriced, but now it's actually very good value. And then the IMLS6 is also a fantastic car that's also really, really cheap as well. So those are some of the guys to watch out for.